this video, we'll be discussing the previous year questions based on the multiplier and the accelerator theories that we discussed in the previous videos. The first question is from 2016 July paper 2. It is a match the following question. Different levels of marginal propensity to consume and MPS. Different values of both MPS and MPC are given. And in the second list, the list 2, it is given the values of multiplier. So we have to match the values of MPC with their corresponding multipliers. So what we can do is that we know the value of investment multiplier, right? So this is MPC and MPS again is directly used in calculating the value of investment multiplier. So in that case, all we have to do is that directly substitute the values of these MPC and MPS in the values of formula for investment multiplier. So in that case, we'll see this here. That means first option one in list 1 was given us, the value was given as MPC is equal to 0.2. So the value of equation for the formula for multiplier, investment multiplier, income multiplier is K is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus MPC. So 1 divided by 1 minus 0.2 will get 1 divided by 0.8, which is equal to 1.25 is the answer for this particular question. That means when MPC is equal to 0.2, we will have the value of 1.25. 1.25 is the value of MPC when it is equal to 0.2. That means option A from list 1 can be matched with option 4 in list 2. Now, the second one, option B, that means MPS, the value of MPS is given, that is equal to 0.5. Again, substituting the value of MPS in the formula for investment multiplier, we get 1 divided by MPS is our formula. So, 1 divided by 0.5 will give us the value 2. That means MPS, when option B, MPS is equal to 0.5 is matched with option 1 from list 2. Now, again, the marginal propensity to save is 0.75, option C from list 1. 0.75, so it can be substituted as 1 divided by MPS, that means 1 divided by 0.75 will get the value as 1.33, which means the value the option C from list 1 can be matched with option 3 from list 2, and option D, the last one, the final one, that is MPC is given as 0.4. That means the value of multiplier 1 divided by 1 minus MPC. So 1 divided by 1 minus 0.4, that is 1 divided by 0.6, which will give us the value 1.66. That means the value of option D, the value of MPC is equal to 0.4. That means our option D can be matched with option 2 in list 2. So these are the values, these are the corresponding values for these questions. That means option A can be matched with option 4, option B can be matched with option 1 in list 2, and option C can be matched with option 3, that is 1.33. That means 0.75 can be matched with 1.33, that is option 3, and option D, MPC is equal to 0.4, can be matched with 1.66, that means option 2 from list 2. So that was the answer for that question. We had list 1 which gave us the values of MPC and MPS, we had to match it with the corresponding with their respective values of multipliers. Now we'll move on to the second question. The question is from 2017 November paper 3. The question is, consider the following statements describing the relationship between marginal propensity to consume MPC and the value of multiplier. So it has, this is a statement question which asks to choose correctly which explains the correct relationship between marginal propensity to consume and the value of multiplier. So first option is higher MPC, lower is the value of multiplier. Option B is higher the MPC, higher is the value of multiplier. And option C is if MPC is equal to 1, value of multiplier will be equal to infinity. So which of the above statements is or are correct? So we have to remember what are we discussed about some of the conclusions that we can derive from the investment multiplier, from the formula of investment multiplier. What are the relationship between marginal propensity to consume, marginal propensity to save, and the level of multiplier? So keeping those in mind, we know that higher the MPC, lower the value of multiplier is a wrong answer, because we know that the value of MPC and the value of multiplier are equally proportional, or they vary proportionally, or there is a direct relationship between MPC and the value of multiplier. So here it is given that higher the MPC, lower is the value of multiplier, so which is wrong. And option B, it is given as higher the marginal propensity to consume, higher is the value of multiplier. So that exactly explains the point that we just now discussed, that is the MPC and multiplier has a direct relationship. So higher the MPC, higher will be the value of multiplier. And when MPC, when the value of marginal propensity to consume is equal to exactly equal to 1, the value of multiplier will be equal to infinity. So this is again the conclusion that we discussed in the previous videos. So if you are not sure, we can just directly substitute the value of 1 in our investment multiplier formula, that is 1 divided by 1 minus MPC, we will get the value as infinity. So under these assumptions, we can directly consider the answer for this question is option 2, that means B and C. Option B, higher MPC, higher is the value of multiplier. When MPC is equal to 1, the value of multiplier will be equal to infinity. So option 2 is the answer for this question. So these were exactly the conclusion that we have, points that we have discussed. That means multiplier varies directly with MPC and indirectly with MPS. That means there is an indirect relationship with marginal propensity to save. That means when one increases, the other decreases. In case of marginal propensity to save, now when MPC is equal to 1, the value of multiplier is equal to infinity. And when MPC is equal to 0, the value of multiplier is equal to 1. When MPC is equal to 0, the multiplier K, the value of K will be equal to 1. Now when MPS, marginal propensity to save, is equal to 1, multiplier will be equal to 1. When MPS is equal to 0, when marginal propensity to zero, save is equal to 0, multiplier will be infinity. And multiplier, the value of multiplier always lies between 1 and infinity. So these are the important conclusions. And the answer for this question is option 2. Another question is from 2018 July paper 2. The question is, if marginal propensity to import is given as 0.1 and the marginal propensity to consume is given as 0.7, the value of income multiplier will be. So since we have since the question we have a marginal propensity to import, that means imports are also considered in this particular economy, which means that it is an open economy model, or we have to use an open economy multiplier, open economy income multiplier, in which imports are also considered. So we have to, in order to find the value of this income multiplier, we have to use the formula for open economy multiplier, which is given as K is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus MPC plus MPM, marginal propensity to consume. 1 minus MPC again is equal to MPS plus MPM is marginal propensity to import. So 1 divided by MPS plus MPM, it is a ratio of 1 over the sum of marginal propensity to save and the marginal propensity to income, marginal propensity to import. So here in the question we have MPC given as 0.7, and so we can derive the value of MPS from MPC. That means 1 minus MPC is equal to 1 minus 0.7, that is 0.3 will be the value of marginal propensity to save. And here marginal propensity to import is given as 0.1. So we can use these two values and substitute in this particular formula. That means K is equal to 1 divided by 0.3, that means marginal propensity to save, plus 0.1, that is marginal propensity to import, is equal to 1 divided by 0.4, that is equal to 2.5. So the value of marginal propensity to import and marginal propensity to save, substituted in the income multiplier formula, we get the value of multiplier as 2.5. So the option in this question is 2.5, that means option 3, 2.5 will be the answer for this particular question, where we considered both marginal propensity to import and also marginal propensity to consume. So this was an open economy income multiplier formula that we used, that is 1 divided by MPS plus MP, M, that is the marginal propensity to import. So the value answer to this question would be option 3, 2.5. Option 3 is 2.5. We'll move on to the next question, that is from 2019 June paper 2. The question is, read the passage given below and answer the questions that follow it. The question is, the passage is, goes like this. Suppose that for a particular economy for some time period, investment was equal to 100, government expenditure was equal to 75, net taxes were fixed at 100 and consumption C was given as the consumption function. C is equal to 25 plus 0.8 YD, where YD is the disposable income and Y is the GDP. So, on the basis of this information given in this particular passage, we have to answer the questions that follows. The first question is that, what is the value of the tax multiplier? That means change in income due to change in taxes, or how much change there will be, how much decrease there will be in income due to a positive change in the tax rate. So, we know that the value of the formula for tax multiplier is minus MPC divided by 1 minus MPC. So, all we have to do is that find the value of MPC and directly substitute it in this formula. So, we know that from the consumption equation that was given here in the question, that is 25 plus 0.8 YD, we know that the value of MPC is equal to 0.8 from the given from the question. So, the MPC is equal to 0.8. Now, all we have to do is to substitute it in the formula. That means delta Y by delta T, that is tax multiplier, is equal to minus 0.8 divided by 1 minus 0.8. 1 minus 0.8 or 1 minus MPC can also be the value of MPS, marginal propensity to save. So, minus 0.8 divided by 0.2 is equal to minus 4. So, the answer for this question is minus 4 is the value of tax multiplier. So, the answer is option D here. That is minus 4, option D. The value of tax multiplier is equal to minus 4, that is option D. Now, the next question is also a continuation of this passage itself. That is, what is the value of government expenditure multiplier? That is delta Y by delta G, that is change in income due to change in the government spending. So, again, we have a formula for government expenditure multiplier, which is again similar to the similar to our investment or income multiplier, that was given as 1 divided by 1 minus MPC or 1 by MPS. So, all we have to do is, we know the value of MPC given here as 0.8. We have to substitute the value in the formula and find the value of government expenditure multiplier. So, here MPC is given as 0.8. MPS, we can substitute, we can use 1 by MPS as a formula here. So, MPS, the value of MPS would be 1 minus 0.8, again which will be equal to 0.2. So, the value of government expenditure multiplier KG will be equal to 1 divided by 0.2, which is equal to 5. So, the answer for this question is option A, 5. All we did was, we had a formula for government expenditure multiplier, that is 1 divided by MPS or 1 minus MPC. So, we have the formula for both, the value of both. MPC is equal to 0.8 as given in the passage. So we substituted the value and find the value as 5. So, the answer for this question is option A given here, that is 5. Now, the next question is from 2019 paper, December paper 2, that is, the question is, for which of the following consumption function the value of the income multiplier K is equal to 4. So, we have 4 consumption functions given here with 4 different values of MPC. That means we have 0.5 here, 0.8, 0.75 and 0.4 given here as MPC. So, what we have to do is that which of these MPC, which of these values of MPC would give us the value of multiplier as equal to 4. So, one of the easiest method of finding which one, what will be the value of multiplier for the value, finding the value of MPC is that instead of checking each and every values of MPC, we know the value of income multiplier, that is 1 divided by 1 minus MPC is the value of income multiplier, and here multiplier is given as, the value of multiplier is given as 4. So, what we have to do is that substitute 4 there, that means 4 is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus MPC. So, we need to find the value of MPC here. So, what value, the question is again, what value of MPC will give us the value of multiplier as 4. So here now solving this, we'll get 4 minus 4 MPC is equal to 1. Again minus 4 into MPC is equal to 1 minus 4. So MPC, the value of MPC would be equal to minus 3 by minus 4, which is equal to 0.75. So the value of MPC equal to 0.75 will give us the value of multiplier as 4. So now what we have, we found the value of MPC. So we have to check which value of multiplier, which consumption function gives us the value of MPC as 0.75, and that is option 3 here. That means 0.75, option 3 here, that means this particular consumption function with MPC as 0.75 will give us the value of multiplier as 4. So your answer for this question is option 3, C is equal to 200 plus 0.75. So that was the easiest method of finding the value of multiplier. The other method is that we can substitute MPC. We have four values of MPC here. We can also find it by substituting each of these values of MPC in this particular equation, and then finding which one of the MPC will give us the value of multiplier as 4. But this is the easiest way. That means all we need to do is substitute income multiplier, the income value of income multiplier here in this equation, and solve MPC to find the value of MPC and find the respective consumption function. So with this, we'll conclude our session on multiplier and accelerator theory. So mostly the questions that were asked were mostly based on income multiplier or government income multiplier, government expenditure multiplier, or either from tax multiplier. So these so we have to definitely separately understand each of these formula, and the questions were mostly direct application alone. This is a easier part to score marks in this case, because since this is a direct application of formula, so application of values and formula here. So with this, we'll conclude our session on multiplier and accelerator. Thank you.